Good morning, students. How are you? Okay, today we start new lesson. I am Vishalu, your computer teacher. Today topic is functions and parts of a computer. Already we know a computer is a electronic machine which is made up of several parts. So, functions of a computer. The main functions of a computer are input, processing and output. Now let us understand what these terms mean. Okay, let us take the examples of a flour mill. In a flour mill, food grains are put into the big funnel. See, food grains are put into the big funnel at the top. This, and they are slowly crushed in the grinder. This part is grinder. So, this one is input. This is processing. The flour comes out of the opening at the bottom. The flour comes out of the opening of the bottle. This is output. So, food grains are put into the big funnel. This function is input. Slowly the grains are crushed. This processing is processing. So, the flour comes out of the opening at the bottom. This process is output. So see, in this entire procedure, food grains put into the funnel. This was input, food grains, processing, grinding and output flour. Understand? The action of grinding the food grains into flour is processing. The flour, that means coming out of the opening, is output. In computer terminology, input, processing and output can be defined as follows. Let's explain one by one. Input, data plus program. Data entered into a computer is called input. What is input? Data entered into a computer is called input. It could be numbers, letters, pictures or even sounds, etc. Next, program. Program is also inputting process. A set of logical instructions given to a computer to perform a task or work on the data is called program. Do you know what is program? The program is a set of instructions or set of softwares. Okay. Next, processing. When the computer works on data according to instruction, it is called processing. So, when the computer works on data input according to instruction, it is called processing. Okay, according to program. Input means data plus program. This way is input to system or computer. Then according to program, what we can do, this type is according to program, that is this method is called processing. The next one is output. Then output is information. Information generated by a processing data is called output. It is displayed by the monitor or printer, by a printer. This means the computer processes input data with the help of a program to generate information output. So, in a computer, the keyboard and mouse are used to enter data and instruction into the computer. Hence, they are input devices. Two input devices, keyboard and mouse. Next, processing unit. CPU. CPU long form is Central Processing Unit. CPU is the brain of the computer. The Central Processing Unit, as the name suggests, is the processing unit. It processes data into the according to instructions program and generates information. The CPU also stores processed data, which you can retrieve whenever you want. Thus, the CPU processes and stores data, program and information. The next, output device, monitor and printer. The monitor display the what information generated by the CPU. If you want, you can print the output with the help of a printer. Hence, the monitor and printer are output devices. Once again, I repeat it. Input devices, keyboard and mouse. Processing unit, CPU. CPU long form is Central Processing Unit. Then next, output devices, monitor and printer. The keyboard and mouse are the two input devices. They are used to enter data or instruction into the computer. First one, keyboard. The keyboard is used to enter data or give instruction to the computer. It is connected to the CPU box. This wire. It is connected to the CPU box with a cable. The keyboard is flat rectangular board. With more than 100 keys. How many keys in keyboard? Do you know? Okay, 104 keys. Okay, 104 keys in our keyboard. These keys can be classified as follows. Letter keys. These are letter keys A to Z. Number keys. This 1, 2, 3. These are number keys. Keys for mathematical operations. See. Bracket. Then. Plus. Minus. Multiplication. Divided by. Keys for. Next part is. Mouse. The mouse is a palm sized plastic device with two or three buttons on it. 1, 2, 3. 3 or 2 buttons. This is optional keys. The left mouse button is the most frequently used button. This. Left, right. Okay. The mouse is kept and moved over the mouse pad on it is underside, there is a spherical rubber ball. And the mouse is also connected to the CPU with the cable. This cable. It is then that the mouse shows where you are currently working on the screen or points to a location. This is arrow. Hence, the mouse is also known as pointing device. See, when you move the mouse, the arrow is also moved. The next part is monitor. The monitor and printer are two output devices. The monitor display the output while print prints the output on paper. The monitor look like TV screen. See, the monitor looks like TV screen. It is connected to the CPU box with the help of cable. It has a power button to switch it on and off, and it also has controls for brightness, contrast, etc. The monitor is also known as visual display unit, VDU, visible display unit. Data entered into a computer is processed according to instruction, and the information that is those generated is displayed by the monitor. See, keyboard, mouse. It is shows whatever type using the keyboard. The monitor screen display whatever you are typing currently. So that reason it is a VDU, visual display unit or display device. Understand? So next part is printer. Printer, any information generated by the computer, this display by the monitor. This information or output can be printed on paper with the help of a printer. A printer can print both text and pictures. The printed copy of the text or pictures is called, it is hard copy. This is because the copy stored by the computer or displayed on the screen is called soft copy. So once again I repeated, the printed copy of the text or pictures is called its hard copy. This is because the copy stored by the computer or displayed on the screen is called soft copy. Understand? So many printers is available in market. Dot matrix printer, inkjet printer and black and white printer, color printer, etc. Next part is CPU. The processing unit is located in the CPU. CPU long form is central processing unit. The vertical box that you see next to the monitor is called the CPU. CPU box, the system unit, the monitor, keyboard, mouse and printer are connected to the CPU box with the cable. See, this is cable wire, this is monitor cable, printer, this cable is mouse cable, and last this is keyboard cable. Processing unit. Processing unit contains the CPU and other electronic components that help the CPU to process input data according to computer and generate information. The CPU controls entire working of the computer, so it is called the brain of the computer. So listen, the CPU controls the entire working of the computer, so that reason we are called the brain of the computer is CPU. On receiving data and instruction from the input device, the CPU decides what to do, how to do and which units will do it, and accordingly it sends message or signals to those units. In our body, we compare it to our brain. So brain is also thinked what to do, how to do. Yes or no? Yes, our brain is control our body. See, this is memory unit, RAM and ROM. RAM, random access memory. ROM, read only memory. As the name suggests, the memory unit stores all the data, programs and information in it. When you enter data into the computer, it first goes to the memory unit. See, memory unit. The CPU takes data from the memory unit and process it to generate information. This information is again sent for storage in the memory unit. The CPU then instructs the memory unit to send the information to the output device. Which is output device? Yes,
monitor and printer is output device. So dear students, understand this topic. These are informations about functions and parts of a computer. So thank you.